I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 78.1. Questioner, was there some problem with the ritual we performed that made it necessary to perform the ritual twice? Answer, I am Ra. There was a misstep which created a momentary lapse of concentration. This was not well. Question 78.2. Questioner, what was the misstep? Answer, I am Ra. It was a missed footing. Question 78.3. Questioner, did this have any detrimental effect on the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. Very little. The instrument felt the presence it has come to associate with cold and spoke. The instrument did the appropriate thing. Question 78.4. Questioner, could you tell me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. The physical complex is as previously stated. There is some slight loss of vital energy. The basic complex distortions are similar to your previous. Asking. Question 78.5. Questioner, the instrument would like for me to ask if there is any problem with her kidneys? Answer, I am Ra. This query is more complex than its brevity certifies. The physical complex renal system of this instrument is much damaged. The time-space equivalent which rules the body complex is without flaw. There was a serious question, due to psychic attack, as to whether the spiritual healing of this system would. India. It did so, but as the need to be reinforced by affirmation of the ascendancy of the spiritual over the apparent or visible. When this instrument began ingesting substances designed to heal in a physical sense, among other things, the renal complex, this instrument was ceasing the affirmation of healing. Due to this, again, the healing was weakened. This is of some profound distortion, and it would be well for the instrument to absorb these concepts. We ask your forgiveness for offering information which may abridge free will, but the dedication of the instrument is such that it would persevere regardless of its condition, if possible. Thusly, we offer this information that it may persevere with a fuller distortion towards comfort. Question 78.6. Questioner, what was the experience that caused the healing of the time-space kidney? Answer, I am Ra. This experience was the healing of self by self with the catalyst of the spiritual healer whom you call Pachitta. Question 78.7. Questioner, thank you. In utilizing the energetic displacements of thought forms energizing the instrument during contact most efficiently, what specifically could we do? Answer, I am Ra. Each of the support group has an excess of love and light to offer the instrument during the working. Already each sends to the instrument love, light, and thoughts of strength of the physical, mental, and spiritual configurations. These sendings are forms. You may refine these sendings until the fullest manifestations of love and light are sent into the energy web of this entity which functions as instrument. Your exact sending is, in order to be the most potent, the creature of your own making. Question 78.8. Questioner, thank you. I am going to go back to an earlier time, if you could call it that, in evolution to try to establish a very fundamental base for some of the concepts that seem to be the foundation of everything that we experience so that we can more fully examine the basis of our evolution. I am guessing that in our Milky Way galaxy, the major galaxy with billions of stars, that the progress of evolution was from the center outward toward the rim, and that in the early evolution of this galaxy the first distortion was not extended down past the sublogos simply because it was not thought of or conceived of, and that this extension of the first distortion, which created polarization, was something that occurred in what we would call a later time as the evolution progressed outward from the center of the galaxy. Am I in any way correct in this statement? Answer, I am Ra. You are correct. Question 78.9. Questioner, we have the first, second, and third distortions of the law of one as free will, love, and light. Am I correct in assuming that the central core of this major galaxy began to form with the third distortion? Was that the origin of our Milky Way galaxy? Answer, I am Ra. In the most basic or teleological sense, you are incorrect, as the one infinite creator is all that there is. In an undistorted seed form, you are correct in seeing the first manifestation visible to the eye of the body complex which you inhabit as the third distortion, light, or to use a technical term, limitless light. Question 78.10. Questioner, I realize that we are on very difficult ground, you might say, for precise terminology. It is totally displaced from our system of coordinates. For evaluation in our present system of language. These early logwa that formed in the center of the galaxy wished, I assume, to create a system of experience for the one creator. Did they then start with no previous experience or information about how to do this? This is difficult to ask. Answer, I am Ra. At the beginning of this creation, or, as you may call it, octave, there were those things known which were the harvest of the preceding octave. About the preceding creation, we know as little as we do of the octave to come. However, we are aware of those pieces of gathered concept which were the tools which the creator had in the knowing of the self. These tools were of three kinds. Firstly, there was an awareness of the efficiency for experience of mind, body, and spirit. Secondly, there was an awareness of the most efficacious nature, or, if you will, significator of mind, body, and spirit. Thirdly, there was the awareness of two aspects of mind, of body, and of spirit that the significator could use to balance all catalyst. You may call these two the matrix and the potentiator. Question 78.11. Questioner, could you elaborate please on the nature and quality of the matrix of the potentiator? Answer, I am Ra. In the mind complex, the matrix may be described as consciousness. It has been called the magician. It is to be noted that of itself consciousness is unmoved. The potentiator of consciousness is the unconscious. This encompasses a vast realm of potential in the mind. In the body, the matrix may be seen as balanced, working, or even functioning. Note that here the matrix is always active with no means of being inactive. The potentiator of the body complex, then, may be called wisdom, for it is only through judgment that the unceasing activities and proclivities of the body complex may be experienced in useful modes. The matrix of the spirit is what you may call the night of the soul or primeval darkness. Again, we have that which is not capable of movement or work. The potential power of this extremely receptive matrix is such that the potentiator may be seen as lightning. In your archetypical system called the Tarot, this has been refined into the concept complex of the lightning-struck tower. However, the original potentiator was light in its sudden and fiery form, that is, the lightning itself. Question 78.12. Questioner, would you elucidate with respect to the significator you spoke of? Answer, I am Ra. The original significators may undifferentiatedly be termed the mind, the body, and the spirit. Question 78.13. Questioner, then we have, at the beginning of this galactic evolution, an archetypical mind that is the product of the previous octave which this galaxy then used as and acts upon under the first distortion so as to allow for what we experience as polarity. Was there any concept of polarity carried through from the previous octave in the sense of service to others or service to self-polarity? Answer, I am Ra. There was polarity in the sense of the mover and the moved. There was no polarity in the sense of service to self and service to others. Question 78.14. Questioner, then the first experiences, as you say, were in monochrome. Was the concept of the seven densities of vibration with the evolutionary process taking place in discrete densities carried through from the previous octave? Answer, I am Ra. To the limits of our knowledge, which are narrow, the ways of the octave are without time, that is, there are seven densities in each creation infinitely. Question 78.15. Questioner, then I am assuming that the central suns of our galaxy, in starting the evolutionary process in this galaxy, provided for, in their plans, the refinement of consciousness through the densities just as we experience it here. However, they did not conceive of the polarization of consciousness with respect to service to self and service to others. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 78.16. Questioner, why do the densities have the qualities that they have? You have named the densities with respect to their qualities, the next density being that of love and so on. Can you tell me why these qualities exist in that form? Is it possible to answer that question? Answer, I am Ra. It is possible. Question 78.17. Questioner, will you please answer that? Answer, I am Ra. The nature of the vibratory range peculiar to each quantum of the octave is such that the characteristics of it may be described with the same certainty with which you perceive a color with your optical apparatus if it is functioning properly. Question 78.18. Questioner, so the original evolution then was planned by the logos, but the first distortion was not extended to the product. At some point this first distortion was extended and the first service to self-polarity emerged. Is this correct, and if so, could you tell me the history of this process of emergence? Answer, I am Ra. As Proem, let me state that the Logwa always conceived of themselves as offering free will to the sub-Logwa in their care. The sub-Logwa had freedom to experience and experiment with consciousness, the experiences of the body, and the illumination of the spirit. That having been said, we shall speak to the point of your query. The first Logos to instill what you now see as free will, in the full sense, in its sub-Logwa came to this creation due to contemplation in depth of the concepts or possibilities of conceptualizations of what we have called the significators. The Logos posited the possibility of the mind, the body, and the spirit as being complex. In order for the significator to be what it is not, it then must be granted the free will of the creator. This set in motion a quite lengthy, in your terms, series of logos as improving or distilling this seed thought. The key was the significator becoming a complex. Question 78.19. Questioner, then our particular logos, when it created its own particular creation, was at some point far down the evolutionary spiral of the experiment. With the significator becoming what it was not and, therefore, I am assuming, was primarily concerned in designing the archetypes in such a way that they would create the acceleration of this polarization. Is this in any way correct? Answer, I am Ra. We would only comment briefly. It is generally correct. You may fruitfully view each logos and its design as the creator experiencing itself. The seed concept of the significator being a complex introduces two things. Firstly, the creator against the creator in one sub-logos into what you may call dynamic tension. Secondly, the concept of free will, once having been made fuller by its extension into the sub-logwa known as mind, body, spirit complexes, creates and recreates and continues to create as a function of its very nature. Question 78.20. Questioner, you stated previously that the choice is made in this third density and is the axis upon which the creation turns. Could you expand on your reason for making that statement? Answer, I am Ra. This is a statement of the nature of creation as we speak to you. Question 78.21. Questioner, I did not understand that. Could you say that in a different way? Answer, I am Ra. As you have noted, the creation of which your logos is a part is a protean entity which grows and learns upon a macrocosmic scale. The logos is not a part of time. All that is learned from experience in an octave is, therefore, the harvest of that logos and is further the nature of that logos. The original logos as experience was viewed in space-time, small, its experience now, more. Therefore we say, as we now speak to you at this space-time, the nature of creation is as we have described. This does not deny the process by which this nature has been achieved but merely ratifies the product.